Genesis Communications Network is. And today, filling in for Mr. Nima Vidati, who is out with his baby girl, Lily June Vidati, his new child with his wife, on paternity leave, we're filling in old dear friend of mine, and this is an internet friend like most people have these days. It's a real friend, my friend Mike. Mike Makes Right. How you doing there, Mike?
I'm doing great, Michael. Thanks for having me. And I'd just like to say, I hope this doesn't make you envious, but we are experiencing 61 degrees in warm, sunny Pacifica, California.
Man. sounds delightful. Sounds like you should be out in a bikini.
It's me on the radio, Peanut.
It's about the only thing delightful.
We're on the radio.
Yeah,
yes.
We're going to talk about that a bit
on the radio
today because Mike and
run, Peanut.
Common. I've known this guy, and usually when I have a guest on here, it's like somebody people have heard of, some, you know, kind of famous in the libertarian community, pundit or blogger or smart guy, or he's a smart guy. Mike's a smart guy, but nobody's heard of him.
It's
he's not
radio.
Used his real name because of his job.
Run the radio.
We're gonna call him Mike Makes
Run the radio.
And he was important to my path to liberty. I've known this guy for about 15 years, probably 17 years, since about 96, would you say?
Yeah, that sounds
radio.
Right.
Yeah, it sounds almost as good as the internet.
We both used to be
and the transmitter is about a mile away.
Recovery. We are both recovering whatevers. We played in a rock band together, not a band anyone's heard of. I don't even remember the name of it. Was it Kitty Feet? Or did we have a name for that band?
I think we didn't even have one, yeah.
I don't think we can play a gig. But let's see, we both were early adopters of recording on computers, of doing digital audio. We both lived in San Francisco. We both lived in L.A. You were my downstairs neighbor in L.A. I told you about I got you a place to stay, basically.
You sure
I got
did.
You an apartment. And we've kept in touch. We're both libertarians. And we
bike messengers, too.
We're both bike messengers, yeah. That's right. That's right. Yeah. And we both have tattoos, but, you know, that's like saying we both breathe these days. I had it before. It was cool. I had my first tattoo in, let's see, I was 18. So 1982.
Wow. So yeah. Only you and some guy in the Navy.
Only like, yeah, sailors and bikers. And
right.
My first tattoo was not like a sailor or a biker tattoo. It was kind of a little girly tattoo. It was like a little musical note over my heart, like tiny, like
Chargers finish off the best in 27.
I was actually 17. I actually lied about my age to get it and got it at a place in, well, I'm not gonna say where it was. It was called like Bill. I'll just change the name. It was called Bill's Archery and Tattoos in upstate New York.
It was Marty's Archery and Tattoos, actually.
Archery shop that had a tattoo gun in the dirty back room.
What else did they sell there? Was it bananas and lawnmowers? Just to make it completely disparate.
Yeah. So San Francisco, they have some zany things. Tell me about some zaniness about San Francisco.
They sure do. Oh, gosh. You know, we shouldn't raise our blood pressure too high in the morning right now. There's so many things to just... In fact, I'm looking at an article right now on SF Gate, and one of the articles is, economic growth hurts the planet.
It's, really?
Yeah, it's those kinds of stories that just make you cringe.
Well, that's the kind of, like, kindergarten economics that they love in San Francisco, and California is a bizarre state because it's basically been an engine to drive the economy of America, and now it's the engine driving the economy into the ground. You know, like you had the fruit boom, you had the, and I mean the things you eat, not the people. You had the fruit boom, then you had the land boom, then you had the Hollywood boom, then you had Silicon Valley. Am I missing anything?
No, that about covers it.
Oh, gold. Yeah, we're missing gold.
Right. Oh, yeah,
the
sure.
Gold rush. It's the first one. And, you know, now you've got this kind of kindergarten economic drives it into the ground. Like, basically, if you're saying economic growth hurts the planet, you're saying we should all be living in ditches pushing berries up our nose. Yeah. And that's using the kind of logic they like to use. Give me some examples of some of the logic fallacies that people shove in your face on a daily basis in San Francisco.
Well, fortunately, I don't live in San Francisco anymore, but...
And we're not outright bashing the town. I mean, it's a great town, some great things that come out of there, some great music, some great literary movements.
All right, signing off.
The Grateful Dead.
Yeah.
We like all that. Now, this is kind of funny. Like, somebody...